To the Point with Michael Williams.
What happens if your home is damaged? Could be from a storm, a fire, something else. Now there's a new way for contractors to be paid, but it is raising questions for homeowners and shaking up the insurance industry. Good morning and welcome. Picture this. You're standing in water up to your ankles in your home. Many of you faced that after Irma, and a contractor says he or she will fix it, negotiate with the insurance company, and get the money directly. It may be a good way of doing that. It may be a bad way, but it looks like this is the way it's going to be done more often in Florida. Joining me now to talk more about this is a lawyer who's worked with both homeowners and contractors in these kind of cases, Javier Delgado, an attorney focusing on property insurance. And sir, thank you for being our guest.
Thank you very much.
The genesis of your visit today was a Wall Street Journal article that I was reading just this week out of Hurricane Irma, which so many have dealt with. I hope you're coming out of it and that you did not suffer too much damage, but they said that the assignment of benefits, and perhaps some of you at home are now familiar with it, is something that is upending, quote unquote, the insurance market in one of the largest U.S. states, Florida, they were talking about specifically. They said the assignment of benefits, or AOB, upending the market, insurers and regulators say the PACs are responsible for driving up insurance rates for some Florida homeowners and spurring a boom in contractor lawsuits against insurers. So first, briefly, describe what AOB is again.
Sure. An assignment of benefits essentially is where a contractor comes in to do work and is asking you to assign your benefits under the insurance policy to the contractor so that the contractor can essentially do the work and request payment directly from the insurance company instead of having to request payment from the consumer and waiting for the consumer to get paid by the insurance company.
What do you think of that idea?
I think that there are, frankly, abuses on both sides. I think that there's abuse on behalf of the insurance company where they're simply lowballing insurance claims and not paying sufficient amounts of money. I also think that
some say, is the argument for the AOB. You step away. I'm the guy with water in my home, let's say. I step away, say, you deal with my insurer. I'll assign that headache to you. I'll assign my benefits
exactly
to you. You go get the money that's justifiably yours for doing the job. That would be a pro for it. The negative is...
Sure. That's a pro for a consumer, absolutely.
Right.
And the negative would be where the contractor essentially comes in and does the water mitigation or does...
Fire, hurricane, anything, does not
do all of the repairs, but then sends in an invoice for a significant amount of money over and above what it really costs to do the work that they've done so far. And so in that situation, there are abuses as well.
And one of the abuses is there are cases with this assignment of benefits where the contractor then can go back to the homeowner if he or she feels they did not get paid enough from the insurer and go after the homeowner for the remaining amount. That's one of the loopholes, is it not? It's one of the things
sure.
the journal talks about.
Absolutely. The contractor always has lien rights under the laws in the state of Florida against the homeowner. So an assignment of benefits is not required in order for the contractor to get paid. It just makes it easier for the contractor to get paid because they're dealing directly with the insurance company.
Let me go through a little bit more of the Wall Street Journal article. Based on current AOB trends, and again, they're looking at Florida, the average statewide homeowner's insurance premium for a $150,000 new home projected to rise from $1,232 to $1,595 in 2022, a 29% increase and more in our part of the state. And the increases are higher than nationwide, and the Insurance Information Institute says it's a direct result of prices going up, up, and away under this assignment of benefits plan. Do you share that concern and believe that's driving this trend?
I don't believe that assignment of benefits is what's driving, maybe the only factor that's driving premiums. I believe that we've had Hurricane Matthew, which even though it didn't make landfall, it did affect many properties on the coast. We now have Hurricane Irma, which has affected, obviously, almost the entire state of Florida. And so you have to consider everything else. In addition, our population has increased approximately 2 million people in the last 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's expected that when you have an increase in population, you'll have an increase in claims. Because obviously more people are owning homes, there's higher probability that there are going to be insurance claims.
They say in the article, other states allow AOB agreements. I assign my benefits, but they have had a larger impact in Florida because a state law requires the insurer to pay attorney fees if more money is awarded after a lawsuit that was initially offered. And they say this is turning into a morass of problems and driving up costs and really creating more headaches.
Well, the attorney's fees is really a red herring, because the reality is that if the insurance company is right and they win the case, they get attorney's fees. And so at the end of the day, it's not the attorney's fees, essentially, that's the issue. It's really whether or not water mitigation contractors should be regulated.
Speak to this criticism. Insurers argue the assignment of benefits in Florida encourages contractors, quoting here, to overcharge insurers for repair work and perform more work than is needed. Is that an abuse that you're seeing happening?
Yes, that is an abuse.
How prevalent?
It's hard to really quantify, but it is an abuse.
It.
Yes, and the reality is that in order for the water mitigation contractor to not abuse the system, there has to be legislation passed where essentially the contractor has to do the repairs first, and then they can submit the assignment of benefits to the insurance company to get paid. In addition, if a water mitigation contractor is negotiating the claim with the insurance company, then there is a very high risk that they are engaging in the unlicensed practice of public adjusting or the unlicensed practice of law.
Because of these lawsuits that we just talked about, and perhaps some of you have been dealing with this at home, maybe you assigned your benefits, and I'd love to hear from you and see what your experience has been, but it argues in the Wall Street Journal, in Miami-Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach counties, and of course on the Treasure Coast, this kind of thing's going on as well, but they said in Miami-Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach counties, where AOB lawsuits, assignment of benefit lawsuits, are most prevalent, one company said its average cost for a water claim has risen from $8,000 3 years ago to $25,000. And critics say this is exactly the kind of abuse that soon is going to be unaffordable, and that the assignment of benefits is really just going to be assigning a lot more pocketbook pain to homeowners.
The value of what they pay to a contractor to do water mitigation work is simply based on the work that's done and the prevailing rate in the industry. And so if they're paying more money because of the water mitigation work that's being done, we have to look at what work is being done and what's being charged for it. Part of the regulation would be that the contractors would have to charge something that's reasonable, something that certainly everyone agrees is worth the, you know, the time and effort and actually equipment that they bring on the property to avoid from further loss.
As you said, one of the pros is if I'm unfamiliar with the system, I've already got headaches, water in my house, let's say.
Right.
I assign the benefits, let others deal with navigating what can be a frustrating system. One contractor said, unless I have an assignment of benefit, I may not get paid, or I won't get paid the right amount. That is the flip side of this argument.
Sure, that's a risk. When the contractor does work at someone's property, the contractor is then subject to getting paid by the consumer. If the consumer doesn't get paid by the insurance company, and the consumer doesn't want to fight to get their money from the insurance company, the contractor could not be paid at all. And that is a real risk.
But, so there's the pro and cons from the contractor and homeowner point of view. This article goes on to state more than 28,000 lawsuits were filed in Florida, more than 28,000 in 2016, up from only 405 in 2006. And that's according to Florida's Department of Financial Services. And they say, again, we're seeing abuses of the system. What was meant to streamline a process is instead inflating cost here, creating a little legal headache we never expected. On balance, do you think assignment of benefits as it currently is constituted in Florida makes sense?
I believe that assignment of benefits have to be regulated in a way that it doesn't negatively affect the consumer. Prior to, 20 years ago, for example, insurance companies recommended contractors and encouraged assignment of benefits to be signed by the consumer so the contractor and the insurance company could work together to get the repairs done. Now, it appears that the insurance companies are against assignment of benefits with contractors. It's a big change between the 20 years.
Before we jump into your final specific advice that perhaps some of you at home, and I'm sure the question is, well, if I'm faced with signing them over, what do I do? Before we do that, you've worked both sides of this. Just briefly tell our viewers, you've worked both sides of this aisle, so to speak. You've seen both sides.
I started in the industry as an insurance adjuster right after college, and I worked my way through law school as an insurance adjuster. Was hired immediately out of law school by an insurance defense firm, and about 12 years ago, I switched sides and started representing the consumer instead of the insurance companies.
On balance, to our viewers today, if somebody says to them, assign your benefits to me, on balance right now, given the concerns that we've discussed here that have been brought up in the Wall Street Journal article, would you recommend somebody right now, after Irma, for instance, assigning their benefits?
I would on a limited basis.
And give us specifics.
Sure. I would recommend a consumer that wants the work done immediately to sign an assignment of benefits that only provides the benefits for the work that's actually completed by the contractor. Some assignment of benefits, unfortunately, are signing all of their rights. They're assigning their legal rights, their extra contractual rights, all kinds of rights.
So what's the specific language for us non-lawyers sitting at home? I can hear you running to grab a pen at home.
Sure.
Right now. So would I be. What specifically do I look for the language if I'm not a lawyer to protect myself before I sign them over?
You want to look for language in an assignment of benefits that essentially limits the assignment to simply the work that has been performed to date. And so that way the work is done, and instead of you having to give a check over to the contractor for the work, the contractor can then contact the insurance company and ask to get paid directly for the work that's been performed, and that's all.
Is there any consumer organization that will help you look over that fine print before you sign away your benefits that you would recommend people going to? Because I have red flags coming up. It sounds easy us sitting here talking about it. I'd still be nervous, I know, doing it myself. What do you say?
I'm not familiar with any consumer organization specifically that deals with assignment of benefits, but you know, there is the Florida Bar, and certainly there's the Florida Association of Public Insurance Adjusters that do represent consumers against their insurance companies.
Bottom line, by the way, some law firms say insurers, in this case, are trying to take away homeowners' rights in pursuing legislation to reduce AOB lawsuits. So again, you have this tug of war going on. Sure. Bottom line, make sure it's a limited assignment of benefits. Know what your rights are. If you have any doubt about the contract, don't sign anything away.
Absolutely.
What do you see in terms of law in Florida? Is there something bubbling up enough after discussions such as this national article in Florida, do you think it's going to change legislation? And if you could sit there and help pin the legislation, what would you do to make it improved?
Sure. My understanding is that there is going to be legislation proposed, if it hasn't been done already, to essentially limit the assignment of benefits to work that has already been performed.
Which you talked about.
Exactly. And that way, the work is actually done, they can prove that everything's been completed, and then they've submitted to the insurance company.
As always, buyer beware when you are signing away anything to read the fine print.
Absolutely.
We hope, if nothing else, that if you have questions, make sure you ask them before you put any pen to paper. Any final quick thought you have?
I just believe that at the end of the day, it's important to just make sure that when you're assigning your rights into the contract, you're assigning them for something that has already been given to you, meaning the work's been done.
It's a tool to use as long as you use it very, very carefully.
Exactly.
And know what you're signing. We appreciate you coming in, your perspective. Sure. We're going to get some follow-up questions. I'll be making sure
to send
them your way for some answers.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for being my guest. I appreciate it. And coming up, Hurricane Irma, much more, and the race for the U.S. Senate in Florida.